Now, let's make a Proteus video. I have already made the video about Proteus, and I show you how it is made, how all things are removable, how we can remove and put again inside its tube the electronic part that works like a SIM card. It is the first electronic that is wireless, that is a very big advantage. Now I will show you, we will talk further about Proteus, but for now I want to make a video about how you can use it. The instructions are on a thread on ECF, so I will read the instructions, and at the same time I will show them to a video, just to know what we have to do when you receive your Proteus. Okay, let's start from the battery installation. For the battery installation, we unscrew the venting cap. We insert the battery with its nose, the nose of the battery, to the electronic. We screw the cap. And you see that an orange light is blinking. If the battery fails to make contact, it means that the adjustable pin of the cap has to be screwed or unscrewed. Let's unscrew it first. Excuse me, let's screw it first so the battery will not make a contact. Screw the cap. Battery doesn't make a contact because the orange LED doesn't open, and you see that the battery is rattling inside the tube. We will unscrew the center post of the venting cap. If you ask me why I didn't make a spring-loaded application, it's because the negative side of the battery has to have a perfect contact to not have current loss. We screw and you see the orange light opens. To my opinion, when you find the right position of the center post of the venting cap, you can do this. Unscrew it again. You will find it one time. I suppose that you will use same batteries every time. Screw well the venting cap to make a very good contact, and then you can screw the rest of the piece, because this is a big piece and you can screw it hard and nice with the battery. When the venting cap can't be screwed well because it is small. Now, we made the contact, we put the battery inside. What we have to do now? Now, Proteus has detected our configuration. But you have to know that Proteus will come to you with a detecting configuration, or maybe with no detected configuration. Why this is happening? Because if it already has a value inside it, that means that it has already recognized the resistance, is because of our experiments to see if all electronics work well. In that case, excuse me, in that case, you have to make Proteus lose this value of the resistance on our experiments, and you have to force it to take a new value, the value of your atomizer that you will put on it. To do this, you unscrew your atomizer. And you will see Proteus is blinking for 6 seconds. And now you see the blue light. That means that Proteus lost the value of the resistance of my experiments. The most possible, I tell you again, is that Proteus will come to you with no value on it. Anyway, now that Proteus lost its value, it can detect your atomizer. But because I want to read you the directions, the instructions of Proteus in a series like they are written on ECF, let me tell you how we block the Proteus. Proteus, after we install the battery, we wait 6 seconds until Proteus locks, as you see. A green light will blink several times, as you saw, followed by a blue light, which stays on for 2 seconds. Proteus is now locked. Let's go further. Attach an atomizer. Connect an atomizer. Excuse me. Connect an atomizer made that its resistance is made with a titanium grade 1 coil. And now we press the button 5 times in quick succession. A blue light will blink 3 times, indicating that your Proteus is now unlocked. And this light will be followed by a red light that blinks while the Proteus is detecting your configuration. Proteus has detected your configuration once the light turns orange and remains on for 2 seconds. This process can take from 1 minute to 3 minutes, depending on the temperature of your atomizer. Let's do it. 5 times, a blue light blink 3 times, and now the red light is blinking because Proteus is detecting your configuration. As we said, when an orange light remains on for 2 seconds, we are ready to vape. This has to be done every time you attach a new atomizer on Proteus. Every time you vape the same atomizer, there is no need for that procedure. Okay, you see that the orange light remained on for 2 seconds. That means that we are ready to go. We push the button and we vape. Okay, now let's go further. Lights that will appear during vaping. Short red blink, Proteus hasn't reached yet the desired temperature because the battery cannot sustain the set of temperature level. Now we are at 280, battery is small, so I suppose that we will not be able to reach the desired temperature. So one short red blink will appear. Video is stacking a little. You saw it. You saw the red blink. I would like to show you the continuous slow light blue blinks, but I can't do it right now because the battery is full. So if you see continuous slow light blue blinks, meaning a blink every three or four seconds. The battery charge is getting low. Either change your battery or consider moving to a lower temperature to prolong battery life. Also, the continuous slow light blue blinks may occur because of bad connection between your battery and the Proteus cap or because of dirty threads. Please erase the small brass bolt inside the cap or clean threads of Proteus. That means that the connected metals are not good, so battery can't give the necessary current. To say it better, battery gives the necessary current, but we have a big loss, so battery seems empty. Also, I can show you now the five slow white blinks when the battery is discharged. Proteus just stops functioning. After the continuous slow light blue blinks that will stay on for maybe 10 minutes, five white blinks means that battery is discharged, and of course you have to change it. You can't vape anymore. Now, steady blue light for 2 seconds means that Proteus is locked because the button was depressed for more than 15 seconds or because the electronic got too hot. That's an extremely rare situation, but anyway, it may happen. To unlock Proteus, press the button 5 times in quick succession. Let's vape for 15 seconds, as I told you before, to see that the electronic will lock. Let's put Proteus in a lower temperature level and vape it for 15 seconds. After 15 seconds, you saw a steady blue light. That means that Proteus is locked. To unlock it, 5 times. Unlock. Now you can vape again. Let's go further. 10 fast red blinks. Your atomizer has a lower resistance than Proteus can handle. Proteus, by the way, can handle 0.4 resistance and more. Because your atomizer is shorting. You have to check your atomizer or make a new coil with a resistance at more than 0.4 ohms. Before you make a new coil, wash your atomizer under running water to remove any small pieces of wire that remain from your previous coil setup, which may be shorting it. In rare situations, the 10 fast red blinks may appear if the current that goes to atomizer is more than VIRS limit, that is 8.8 amperes. Let's short Proteus. Thank you. Excuse me, 1 minute. I don't want to lose the configuration, so I lock it because the green lights means inform me that I have removed the atomizer, and if I want to put the same atomizer, it would be I have to lock it to not lose the value of the atomizer. Maybe better because screwdriver doesn't do a good job. Better I have to put a base of. Base of Telemachos, like I did on a previous video for Cibrillion to sort it. Put the base that I hope it will sort the atomizer and try to unlock Proteus. Sorry, video stacks again. Okay. No, it doesn't see atomizer. I have to sort it in another way. 1 minute. Let's try with the pin inside that touches the 5-10 threads. Still just doesn't see atomizer. Let's lock it to not lose the value. Okay, another way. Touch the two poles with a screwdriver. Push the button. You see the 10 quick red blinks, means that atomizer is sorting. Let's go further. Steady orange light for 3 seconds. Your battery is damaged. Please don't use it anymore and recycle it in the proper way. I don't have a damaged battery, unfortunately, to see this steady orange light. Now, the menu. That's the light you will see on Proteus. So, let's see the menu. The atomizer, unlock it, vape, the app menu, it is when we want to increase the temperature. We push the button three times and we keep the button depressed for 1 second. Look. 1, 2, 3 and keep. It stays open. Now it is counting. Don't pay attention to it. Let's do it again. Push the button three times and keep the button depressed for 1 second. 1, 2, 3. Open. Now, in every push, the temperature raises per 10 Celsius degrees. In every push. Now, you see that the red light blinks, means that we reach the maximum temperature that Proteus works, that is 280 Celsius degrees. We will go to the down menu, that is the same as the up menu, but now we don't push three times and keep the button, we push four times and keep the button. 1, 2, 3, 4 and keep. Red light blink, red light opens. Okay, let's do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4 and keep. 1 down, 2 down, 3 down, 4 down, 5 down, 6 down. In every push, you go down 10 Celsius degrees. Now we count 6 times. We went down 6 times, that means 60 Celsius degrees. To lock Proteus, we push 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Lock. The blue light will stay on for 2 seconds, indicating that your Proteus is now locked. Unlock Proteus. 5 times again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Unlock. A blue light blinks 3 times, indicating that Proteus is unlocked. Check the set temperature. We can go either to up or to down menu. Let's go to up menu. And either the red or the green light, turn on. We will release the button. Do it again. 1, 2, 3 and keep. Release. An orange light will start blinking slowly and each blink indicating one step in temperature. Each step is 10 Celsius degrees and the total number of blinks will let you know what temperature you are at. One blink indicates 180 Celsius degrees. Two blinks indicate 190 degrees. So, let's see at what Celsius degrees we are. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. 1 is 180. 190, 200, 210, 220. So, we vape at 220 Celsius degrees. Let's go to the down menu to go to the lowest temperature to see that the light will blink only one time. Excuse me, I went to the up menu. Now we are at the lowest temperature and I want to count if really I am at the low temperature. the light will blink one time. One time. Let's go to the highest temperature. Sorry, my video is sticking a little, so I'm watching the screen instead of watching the real Proteus. We are at the highest temperature. Let's go down because the video was a little slow. Okay, let's go up. Now I am at the highest level of temperature. As you see, I can't do anything else because the red light just stops responding. Now, let's count. We have to count 11 times because we are 180, 190, 200. 210, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. 11 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay. Now, you can stop LED from blinking, because sometimes you want to go up like this, but you want to think a little, so the light starts blinking. You can push the button one time to stop the blinking. You can stop this blinking, and you can stop with one push of the button any blinking of the light. For example, your light will blink when your atomizer is out of liquid. It will blink 10 times in a green color. You can push the button to stop it. You will see it in a while. Now, changing the atomizer. If you want to vape again on the same atomizer, without changing the coil, lock Proteus and then disconnect the atomizer. We lock Proteus and now disconnect the atomizer. Okay, nothing is happening. Proteus is keeping the value of the resistance of the atomizer, and you will vape it again while you screw it again on Proteus. So, we reconnect the atomizer, unlock Proteus, and vape. If you forget to lock Proteus before disconnect the atomizer, the green light will blink to inform you that you forgot to lock Proteus. You have 6 seconds to lock it before Proteus loses your settings. Let's see what will happen when we unscrew the atomizer. It blinks. Okay. It shows you, it tells you that you have to lock Proteus. I stop blinking with one push of the button. That's another blinking that I can stop. Okay. So, lock Proteus, unscrew your atomizer as we did before. Do what you want to do with your atomizer, but don't change the coil, because you have to redetect the new coil. So if you have the new coil still on this atomizer, screw it, unlock, vape. Let's go further. If you want to vape with a different atomizer, or change the coil on the existing atomizer, we disconnect the old atomizer and we let Proteus lock by itself. The green light will blink 6 seconds, as you see, and then the blue light will stay on for 2 seconds. That means that Proteus lost your settings. Now, we connect the new atomizer, we unlock Proteus, as we did on the first minutes of this video, we wait to detect our configuration, Proteus will blink red while detecting your configuration, and the process will finish when an orange light remains on for 2 seconds. This may take from 1 to 3 minutes depending on the temperature of your atomizer. Then you will be ready to vape again. Now, as you see, the menu is very easy. It's very easy, you get used to it, extremely easy. It's not complicated. The only you have to do is, while vaping, to go... One minute, to get the camera. While vaping, like this, if you want to go up, you go 1, 2, 3 and keep. Now we are at the final stage. Let's say that we want to go down. You go down right now 40 Celsius degrees because you pushed the button 4 times. Let's say that you want to go up. 1, 2, 3. One, two, three. Three up. Okay, let's go, that is 30 Celsius degrees. Let's go 50 Celsius degrees down. One, two, three, four, five. Okay. And if someone wants to see the temperature that is vaping, something that I don't think that anyone would like to know very often, because it doesn't matter at what temperature you vape, the only it matters is if you are happy with the vaping at the specific time. Let's go up, 1, 2, 3, and keep, 1, 2, 3, 4. We went up 40 Celsius degrees. Let's go down, 1, 2, 3, 4, and keep, 1, 2, we went down 20 Celsius degrees. Some very important things about vaping on a temperature control device. First of all, about Proteus, it would be nice to operate it up to 230 Celsius degrees to have a decent battery life. Especially on the G-atomizers, Penelopes, you can gain more battery life by not opening a lot the liquid control. Because we have temperature control, we don't have a burn taste. So, if we close the liquid control on G-atomizers, this is a very special feature that works on temperature control devices because the liquid control can produce, can help electronic and your battery to stay alive for more time because the battery doesn't need to send a lot of current to an overfluted atomizer. It can reach the temperature easier, so the energy that battery has to give is a lot less. Keep threads and contacts clean, otherwise your Proteus and your any of your temperature control devices will not work as you expect. And not only temperature control devices, all electronic devices. The threads of the coil must not touch each other. Okay. We must make space threads. Now, the legs of the coil, I mean the distance between coil and posts that keep wires should be the shortest possible or covered by wick. I prefer to be the shortest possible because if sometimes you cover them by wick, maybe a thread of your atomizer will go red only because you covered the legs and the legs now have more load than the rest of the threads. What you have to do, to my opinion, in all temperature control devices is that the distance between coils and posts that keep wires should be the shortest possible. That's why I made the Sprinkomizer. It works sometimes with temperature control devices. It depends on how it contacts, how the spring contacts the post. If the contact is good, then there is no problem on temperature control devices because the Sprinkomizer doesn't have legs on its resistance, so it's the perfect solution for temperature control devices. Now, the coil should be wound tightly and with a uniform tightness around the entire length of the wick. Keep all your electrical connections tight. Don't leave loosey connections like something like a loosey cap. You have to screw it well, or don't leave a loosey connection here or on the cap or between Proteus and atomizer. If you see that the green light blinks more often than usual on a new wick, don't worry. Just give wick some time to be saturated. The last step of temperature, that is 220 Celsius degrees, is very strong, so green light will blink more often than the other steps, just to prevent a burnt wick. If Proteus gets stuck, release the connection to the battery. Wait 3 seconds. And reconnect the battery. you will not lose any of your settings. Proteus checks per time to time your configuration, so when this procedure starts, the red light starts blinking slowly, don't interrupt it. You will be ready to vape again when the orange light stays on for 2 seconds. The range of titanium wires size that are recommended for atomizers, which will go on Proteus, are 0.20 millimeters up to 0.50 millimeters. Now, other specifications of the electronic part. Atomizer detection, as you saw. This atomizer detection is very special because you can vape on hot atomizers. Even if you put a hot atomizer on Proteus, this is a worldwide patent, you can still vape it without worrying that your atomizer is hot and the value that it will take will be wrong. This is very important, of course, because the wrong value will lead you to burn taste and wrong temperatures and all this stuff. Working atomizer check. You saw that if the atomizer is working, then nothing will appear. The light will not blink, will not open, just nothing. If it is your atomizer is shorting, you will see the red wake. Blinks, and if your atomizer doesn't make a contact or the resistance is broken, the green light will blinks, meaning that there is no atomizer on Proteus. Battery check, as you saw, sorry, you didn't show it yet. If your battery is damaged, then an orange light will stay open for 2 or 3 seconds, and let me see if I remember well. Yes, steady orange light for 3 seconds means that your battery is damaged. Lock mode, you see that Proteus is locks. We have 15 seconds cutoff. Short circuit protection, you saw that. Reverse battery protection, reverse battery protection. Let's see it. First of all, Proteus needs a battery with a nose to work. Okay, if we put the battery the wrong way, then Proteus will not fire. You see that the light doesn't go orange and it doesn't vape, of course. Over-discharge battery protection. The battery will stop when it reaches the limit of 3.4 volts. Thermal monitoring. If the electronic goes hot, the Proteus will lock. We can't see this right now because it is almost impossible to make the electronic go so hot. Atomizer doesn't work at all when you go from one menu to another, something that saves battery life and also doesn't annoy the user. You don't want your atomizer to work. It works, the electronic, not Proteus. The electronic of Proteus works with one 3.7 volt battery, with two 3.7 volt batteries, and with two 3 volt batteries. This you will be able to see it when we will put a Proteus electronic, the VIR, on bigger GZ devices. It remembers your last setup, meaning that if you change the battery or if you untouch the battery and touch it again, you will still be able to vape because you don't lose your settings. Uh, The upper limit is 8.8, as we said before. The volts upper limit is 8 volts. The resistance range is 0.4 to 1.35. The electronic is the shortest and thinnest electronic PCB today. When I say shortest, I don't mean shortest by 1 or 2 millimeters or 3 millimeters or 5 millimeters or 1 centimeter. We are talking for a huge difference. This electronic is only 20 millimeters. All components are all attached to one PCB. It is wireless. It has also a mechanical button, a so small electronic that is wireless. I think that all electronic engineers will appreciate the way it is made. Not only engineers, but also the customers too, because the electronic goes on and off like a SIM card. All things can be removed on a Proteus and can be assembled again. It's like a mechanical mode. It's not an electronic style mode where you can't remove anything, you can't touch anything. Sorry that I say that, but here in Greece, when we see something fixed like this, we say that this is a China star. I don't mean anything about any other model, of course, sorry, but that's only my opinion. I wanted to make not a high-end, but a very high-end mod like Proteus. That's my opinion again, I say it again, where even the electronic part will be removed and go again inside the tube, like it was just a metal part, like the rest of the parts on a construction. You didn't see it on this video, but the Proteus has a mechanical button. The button is on a PCBA. On PCBA, there is no button, electronic button like all the other devices. We have a mechanical button that is an axis that is sticking like this on the PCBA, and the button just hit this axis. We have battery auto balance. That means that Proteus vapes without new adjustments, even if battery is down to 3.45 volts. I mean by this that when Proteus can't reach the desired temperature, it has this feature, the auto balance, to vape lower, but still vape without the need of the customer to go lower, to vape, and then go lower until the battery is totally discharged. It simply doesn't annoy the vapor. It vapes until the battery ends, and that's it. You know, when you run out of liquid, we can do that by screwing the liquid control, closing the liquid control. Let's try to vape with the liquid control closed, and go to the final step, the higher step of temperature, because that way we will see much quicker the green lights that means that we are run out of liquid. I have to tell you that here we have another special feature where when we run out of liquid on Proteus, Proteus doesn't vape and vape and vape, and the smoke goes lower and lower and lower, and this endless thing never stops. Proteus knows how much smoke you produce at the specific temperature, and it stops when the smoke goes a little lower than normal. If you have noticed, the rest of the devices, they vape and they produce less smoke and less, and they it seems that they will never stop. Let's see what Proteus can do. As you see, we have enough liquid inside, even if we close the liquid control, because the wick is saturated, so there is no reason for Proteus to stop working. smoke is still big. Stop, you see the green light blinks 10 times. That shows that you maybe still have a liquid on your wick, but there's no reason to vape so small liquid and produce so small smoke. It stops because the smoke went a little lower than your setting temperature. Let's do it again. Of course, we don't have a burn taste. Liquidity was saturated while I was explaining to you what's happening. It stopped responding, as you see, and we have, sorry, video start again, the green lights. Another very special feature of Proteus, and I say all these features special because they don't exist on any other electronic mod, is even if a lot of years passed from where we started with my electronic engineer to making the temperature control devices, even if a lot of years passed, no one managed to have these features. One more feature, it vapes the same way in all environments, very hot or very cold. If, for example, with another device, you take a value of resistance when you are out and you try to vape, then you will always vape at a low temperature because the value that the atomizer is cold is, for example, minus 10 Celsius degrees, so you will always vape at 10 Celsius degrees more. If you try to take a value on a very hot place where the temperature is around 40 Celsius degrees, you will always vape at 20 Celsius degrees more. That is very bad for you because you will vape acrolein and all this stuff. As you see, you know when battery is low or when it's out of range, because if it is low, the slow blue light blinks will start, and the five white blinks will follow after 10 seconds when your battery is out of charge. And the maximum power of the electronic is not 25 watts as I was planning to make it, but is 30 watts. Of course, Proteus can't reach 30 watts because of the battery, but it can reach them when we will put it on bigger devices. That's all. Maybe on the next video of Proteus, I will assemble and disassemble it one more time to see how easy the electronic part goes on and off. That means two things, to my opinion. The first is that there's no reason to send me your device back. Just take off the electronic, send it back or throw it away, and I will send you a new electronic. When this can be done on other devices, that you have to send them back to the manufacturer to fix them. Also, it is a great electronic for modders. Most modders, including me of course, don't know a lot of things, or they don't know anything about connecting electronics or soldering or putting glues and all the stuff to glue the screen and make buttons, etc. If a modder buys Proteus, he can just go to his machine shop and make a tube like this, the brass tube. He can make it from stainless steel, of course, or any other metal, and put like a SIM card to the Proteus inside, and he will have he will have made all his mechanical mods electronic ones. It is a very easy way for the modders to make this on their machine shops, and they will not be forced to make anything else than a metal part, and they will put inside Proteus. They can sell very easy electronic devices, and they can update their existing customers with electronic with Proteus electronic. With VR. That's it for now. Maybe instead of making another video, let's make this video a little longer to show you how Proteus is made inside. You know it already from previous videos, but because they were made 4 years ago, maybe we have to do it one more time. Let's take out the cup. This is the AD ring, it's exactly like a Steribon. This is the cup. That is exactly like a Steribon, just smaller. We have inside this spring-loaded application. Okay, just like a Steribon, same thing. Because not all people have a Steribon, let's take it off. See how easy it is made and how effective. I will not show you exactly what is going on inside, but it is just a spring and a moving pin. It's a very easy construction. It has great conductivity. And here you will see a plastic. This is a small plastic. We put it inside the cup, and we put with O-rings the center post. Center post is with O-rings to be moved freely and nicely, and not to have problems with leakage. Put the AD ring. Now, let's see the vending cup. The vending cup is very easy. You see a bolt that we can unscrew it. And, that is the adjustable pole to make all batteries fit well. And inside we have a spring, nothing else. This is just a piece of metal, and we have a spring. Just to keep the tense of the bolt while we put it in place. So if we leave it like this, it doesn't roll, it doesn't get screwed or unscrewed just for fun, because the pressure of the spring keeps it in a specific place. This is just a cube with the battery inside. Let me focus a little. And here is the electronic part. 1 minute to unscrew it. I put the nose of this, let's call it pliers, to the two holes, to the two side holes, like this. Sorry, video stuck again. Let's wait a little. Okay, grab it and unscrew this bolt. The fact that the electronic part is wireless is fantastic, to my opinion. It is one of the best features of Proteus. Now, let's push it from the other side, and the electronic will come out. That's it. There is nothing special on this tube. It's just a tube that has a button on it and a skylight. The skylight is very easy to be removed. You put the pliers under the tube and push the skylight a little, and then grab it with your nail to take it off. here is the skylight, and if you want to take off the button, you do exactly the same. You push it. Let me show you on camera. You see the button. I push it like this. Sorry. Let's do it again. We have to be careful, but I'm trying to show you on camera too, so it's not very easy. What you see here is a button. A button is just a piece of metal, nothing else, with an O-ring on it, and a small spring, so the button can go on after every pushing. We put the O-ring to this piece of metal. It's just one piece of metal. It's not like a stair gun. We put the spring. Put the spring and push it on the tube. Do some circling movements so O-ring can go inside well. It didn't go well. 1 minute, take it off again. Maybe the spring got stuck somewhere. Putting some Vaseline on O-ring, it will help a lot, of course. If it doesn't go inside, you can push it on your table and it will finally go. No, it went inside. It's working, as you see. Skylight is much more easier. Put it on the hole with the O-ring. Skylight is in. And let's put again the electronic inside its tube. Put the bolt. Grab it again with this kind of pliers. And screw it as hard as you can to keep electronic in place. That is Proteus. An electronic, mechanical or a mechanical electronic device. I like to call it that way. And maybe I can find an even better name. Anyway, I hope that you will be very pleased with Proteus. To my opinion, it's a fantastic device, not only because it is small, but because of its wireless style and his mechanical style of construction. Thanks for watching. Have a great night.